wouldn't be week one if we did not touch on the rookies, those debuts that really stood out, and there's no better way to do it than using the PFF play-by-play grading system. So Sam, let's run through a few rookies that really impressed in their debuts, starting with Fred Warner of the San Francisco 49ers at linebacker. He was all over the field making plays.
Yeah, we expected this to be an area of concern for the 49ers without Reuben Foster on the field, but Fred Warner stepped in there and almost didn't miss a beat from Foster. He led the team in defensive stops, five of them, led the team in tackles. There was a forced fumble in there. There was a pass breakup. He was all over the field on defense for the 49ers and looked like the latest linebacking stud that the 49ers have managed to find in the draft. It's incredible the run they've been able to have.
They've really been rolling through good rookie linebackers. When Warner and Foster are playing together, it could be a really nice tandem. The other guy that really stood out for us, Gennard Avery. We could call him a linebacker. We could call him an edge defender. That's what he played at college in Memphis. And for the Cleveland Browns yesterday, three pressures and really got after the quarterback, showed those pass rushing skills from college.
Yeah, and another guy with a forced fumble to his name, making big plays, turning over the ball. Gennard Avery looks like the player he looked like in college, which is he may not be the conventional body type when it comes to an edge rush. He's a little more stocky, compact, doesn't have the length you want for those big edge rushers, but he just beats his man consistently and applies pressure on the quarterback. Did it all the way through college and has done it so far. Made our team of the week ahead of Von Miller, Steve.
Yeah, pretty impressive for a debut for Avery. And we're not a fantasy show by any means, but I would imagine that Will Disley was probably the number one pickup when it comes to waiver wire. Everybody's scrambling to figure out who is this guy, because he was pretty much a blocking tight end coming out of Washington, one of our highest run blocking grades last year at tight end for all of the draft class tight ends. And he comes out and he's a big receiving threat for Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks?
Yeah, three catches for 105 yards. I mean, those are deep threat wide receiver numbers, not tight end numbers, not blocking tight end numbers anyway. And if you look at the tape, there's some incredible moves after the catch, some impressive moves just to get open in the first place, but caught one pass on a dig, busted tackles left and right, and almost got his way in for a second touchdown as well. Some of these numbers were helped a little bit by the fact that the Broncos, for some reason, kept putting Bradley Chubb in coverage on Disley, and that's not going to work.
You think that's not sustainable?
I do. I do think you want your pass rusher rushing the passer, not covering the tight end deep down the field. But you can't take anything away from Disley. He played a fantastic game, looked like a legit receiving threat, not a blocker.
Back to linebacker, and it was Jawan Bentley of the New England Patriots who impressed the entire preseason. He was our highest-graded run-stopping linebacker in the nation last year, went in the fifth round, and you wrote him up in our draft guide, and you said, I'm really intrigued by this guy. If he goes to the right situation, he could be good. Patriots might be a perfect situation for him. He had a great week one.
And that's the key. There may be no better situation for a linebacker with an unusual skill set for today's NFL to land in than the New England Patriots, because no team is better at putting a player in the position to succeed at minimizing what he does badly than the Patriots. And that run defense grade showed up here. 87.7 run defense grade for this game. And he wasn't exposed in coverage the way you feared he might be, judging from his college tape.
Absolute hammer in the run game. Last name, though, it is Denzel Ward, Cleveland Browns, the number four overall pick, two interceptions in his debut. The big debate was the Bradley Chubb versus Denzel Ward at number four discussion. We were big proponents of Ward at number four, and it looks like he's already helping to solidify Cleveland's pass defense.
Yeah, and look, Bradley Chubb got some pressure in that game, so you can't hate on him too much. But, you know, Chubb was exposed in coverage, not the thing he should be doing against Disley, whereas Ward was turning the ball over. Ward had two interceptions, one of which was a phenomenal play. Marcus Peters-esque, dare we say, coming off his guy, reading where Ben Roethlisberger wanted to go with the ball, diving in front of it to make the interception. The other one's a little bit luckier, just lands in his hands. But this is a guy that was shutting down significant portions of his field and making plays on the ball to turn it over. I think had a significantly higher effect on his game than Bradley Chubb did in his.
Did give up a touchdown to Antonio Brown, really tightly contested catch in the end zone, but hey, it's Antonio Brown. He's going to win a few, might not be the last one.